NCTV45, the train, anytime on your time.
Left hand, then you won't be able to see your
but
hand
people
go
need to know how, like how folks, well this is produced
to the Padula Show Extra featuring J&J.
Right,
I'm finally getting that. Thank you. We are live via tape delay from the Confluence in the beautiful downtown of Pittsburgh. Larry's kicked us out. So.
No, he did not.
No?
Don't say that about our good friend Larry. We love Larry's in Poland, Ohio, 224. He has wine. He has beer. In fact, he has Hillary Clinton's new wine.
19 crimes.
One sip.
Check us out.
That's right. And you will feel that you are above the law. We have some great news for you. And probably at the end of the month, Hillary Clinton has given us permission to produce her new series. And that's all I'm going to say. Mm-hmm. So it should come out by the end of March. Hillary Clinton. Dramatic role. Oh my God, boy, does that role.
Really, as you've never seen Hillary before.
No.
We see different incarnations of Hillary on a daily basis.
Right.
We see the liar and then the liar, and then sometimes we'll see the liar along with the liar. And it's nice to see a new side of Hillary. It's going to be fantastic.
You know, when we auditioned her and you see. It's just natural, a natural born liar. Yeah. Not even a stretch for her.
And what's interesting is many folks say how charismatic she is in person and how endearing and personable she is. We found none of that to be true. She's very cold, calculated, and distant. But just another side of Hillary that you'll get to see.
But she did make that wine, the new brand of wine. Yes. 19 crimes, right. Larry sells it. Everybody loves it. Wow, I didn't know that was going to happen. You know, some interesting things too.
See, we're so high end here on the Padula Show Extra that we do our taping via an iPhone. So when I get a message, it always freaks James out.
No, you didn't have to say that. It could have been
right
like a that could have been like a teleprompter thing.
Well, they don't see it. We see it.
That's right.
Oh, hence the teleprompter, I guess.
I'm very excited. I didn't bring
lack of sleep. Okay.
You what?
I'm tired.
You're allowed to be tired. It's early in the morning. That's why when we get here, early in the morning, Patty Dixie from Confluence, downtown Newcastle, great place. So is Two Rivers. Great coffee. Should right up.
I will say, I love Larry's. You know
Larry's is our home base.
He's close to my heart. He's a wonderful gentleman. His wife is an incredible woman.
Daughter's nice.
Yeah, never had the pleasure of meeting Larry or his wife, but this is what I hear from the employees of Larry. His coffee just isn't as good as the Confluence, because the Confluence...
Who said that? Who said that?
I did, just now.
Listen to me, I love his wines. Well, you saw, we did like a commercial for Larry's. Mm-hmm. It was a great episode, and Larry's a great guy, and he deserves that.
Yeah.
So, I you know what? I'll tell you what I'm really happy about this week.
What's that?
Ham the monkey. I am so, I didn't know, you know, like how we usually, well, in fact, I have it right here. This is the...
Oh, we can't make fun of that book.
No, we're not.
That's a really good book. Seriously, no, you can pull another one out.
All right, anyway.
Rick the monkey.
No.
No, Ham the monkey.
Yeah, the Ghost of Africa. Let me explain this to you, the Ghost of Africa. And this is about Ham the monkey. I don't know. I'm going to just, you probably don't even notice. You're going to probably look at me and say, you know what?
Heard of Ham the monkey.
I don't know this. Well, back in the 50s, when we did the Sputnik thing,
we sent Ham the monkey up into space.
We did.
He was the original astronaut.
How'd you know that? I thought you didn't know this.
I'm good. Well, I may have been born in 1973. but I know about the space program.
All right. So, pray tell, then,
NASA.
Why did they send up a monkey to space?
Because his physical attributes are the closest to the human without risking human life, because we didn't know exactly what space would do to the human body.
So Russia said, what did we learn from Russia then?
Imploded and or exploded, froze or heated up beyond our
FUBAR.
Capacity to
right.
hold it.
FUBAR.
The Russians just don't give a crap.
What did they send into outer
a dog.
Space? Right, and what happened to the dogs?
They died. Too many G's. Their internal organs could not handle the G-force of...
Right. So then
he just thought I was just another pretty face.
No.
No, I'm incredibly
intelligent. Well, you know, and then comes... why did they call him Ham the Monkey?
Because he was really funny and a practical joker.
And he did talk shows.
Right.
And he would ham it up, so hence the nickname Ham the Monkey.
Yeah.
Now, let me ask you this one, old wise one. Old wise one.
I'm an old soul. Young man, but I'm an old soul.
What happened? How did they train Ham? What techniques did they use so that while he was in outer space, as far as food and utilizing a bathroom, what did they use for him? And then there's a funny story that follows that, because it's in this book, The Ghost of Africa. It was actually written by Ham the Monkey.
They took him up in a Zeppelin aircraft and pulled high G's up into the air and then decelerated the Zeppelin almost nose down, and it gave a minute or two of weightlessness so they could train. Might have been a 707.
No, airplane. Wrong again, Moose Breath. The reason why that was Ed McMahon did. Listen, Ham the Monkey, they trained him for 2 weeks with electric shock.
Therapy.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I've done it.
To Ham?
No.
You actually used electric shock?
Electric
really?
Shock. Yeah.
So here,
he's a monkey.
The monkey, Ham.
Mm-hmm.
Then he opened up a chain of restaurants. Which was
called Hambone.
What?
Creole food.
Wow!
Mm-hmm.
And he set up shop down in New Orleans.
The caveat to that, a lot of people don't know about that story, is they actually had to shut him down. a lot of people thought they were serving pork, and it turned out he was serving monkeys.
Yeah.
Hambone.
In fact, it got to a point where it was so hot down in New Orleans, and this is why they had to shut him down, the building inspectors, the code guys, the code enforcement. Is because he would
throw feces when he was angry.
In a fan.
Yeah.
And that's when they came up with the saying,
when the poop hits the fan.
Fan.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was all over. No, I knew that because a lot of people complained because their grits were kind of nutty and they didn't
and brown.
Really, yeah. So
grits are not supposed to be brown.
No, or nutty.
Mm-hmm. No.
Or nutty. So there it is. There's your Ham story. And ladies and gentlemen, only here.
Good way to argue, though, to throw feces, I find. It's a very effective way to shut down your opponent. I think Donald Trump should try that in the next debate. I think.
Why do you say
really
that?
Well.
No, he's not going to debate anymore. He doesn't have to. Why are you saying that about him? How do we go from Ham the Monkey to Trump? Trump's not a monkey. Listen,
my only hope for anything good to happen as far as the presidential campaign, because I'm not normally one of those people that are the lesser of two evils, but
right.
this time around it's definitely looking like the lesser of two evils. I'm actually hoping that somehow Ben Carson becomes the vice president candidate, and when Trump gets assassinated within the first week and a half of his presidency, we will have a competent individual that can run the country.
But the only problem with Dr. Ben Carson, is he would have to forfeit or give up on his rice.
That's rice. Condoleezza.
Oh, Condoleezza
yeah,
rice.
She was in the previous cabinet, George W.'s.
They kept her in a cabinet.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's where she got her last name, Rice.
Rice.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah. it was right.
It was very painful, she told me. Yeah. She had to do a lot of yoga after that because they kept her in a cabinet.
Honestly, that what? Condi has retired from politics, because honestly, I think she would make a very good president.
She's an
incredibly intelligent woman.
And she's a pianist right now.
She's a pianist.
Pianist.
Plays the piano.
Pianist.
A pianist.
Piano. So, I'm really happy, but I feel bad you feel that way about Trump. Who do you feel? Well, let me ask you a question.
Most every one of the politicians has something going for them that I admire, with the obvious, brutal exception of Hillary. I like the fact that you can't buy Bernie Sanders.
No.
All his campaign funds come directly from his supporters.
$25 a person?
Yeah, is his maximum that he'll accept.
It's not bad.
So I applaud that. He is very convicted, or is very strong.
He's convicted of what?
Of rape.
Don't say that.
Of the capitalistic enterprise.
Oh, okay. Say, wow, wait a minute. They would shut us down.
Oh, it's Duke Lacrosse all over again.
But that's right. They would shut us down.
If you didn't know, Duke Lacrosse was falsely accused of rape. But yeah, most of them have things about them that are endearing, that bring them back to you. And Trump, I think the thing that I like about him is it's clear, with the Republican Party threatening to split, and I forget what
he's
going to
leave
that.
You said
split and go to the independents, that he does have all the politicians scared.
He
which
does.
Makes me think that
except
that
for
might
Ham
be a good thing.
Ham
well he was I, never a politician. He did run for Senate one time, but he lost by the slimmest of margin. That whole restaurant debacle really cost him.
He hurt himself. I heard he slipped on a banana peel and hurt his back, and he couldn't.
Because he's a monkey.
That's what I heard. I wasn't trying to be funny. I'm serious.
He slipped on a banana peel because he's a monkey.
No. How about if somebody else did that?
He was about to hop on the tire swing, and he slipped on a banana.
Here, let me tell you this wise guy, and this is why. Did you hear what happened to Jared Fogle? The subway guy?
Yes, he got beat up.
You know why?
In the prison yard.
You know why?
Because he slipped on a banana peel?
No, because he's the one, to my understanding, and I saw the videotape of this from Ham's restaurant, the monkey that was in Sputnik or whatever. He's the one that threw the banana peel. I guess what they were doing is having some of the prison inmates go out and do some sprucing up for the spring. And Ham had a flower bed in front of his restaurant.
Okay. You do realize that monkeys live to be about 30 to 35 years old, correct?
Yeah, I know. I know.
If he was doing that now, that would make him about 68 years old.
Yeah, 68 years old. And how do you do that, Jared?
Outer space was good to him then, huh?
It was. And then how do you do that to him? You throw the banana peel. Well, guess what? Word got back. I'm not saying there were any snitches, but word got back when he went back to his 8x10. He took a beating.
Well, interesting caveat to that as well. They've actually had to widen his cells because he's put on a lot of weight in prison. So it is now 8x11.5.
Really?
Yes, he's ballooned up to about 450 again.
No way.
Yes.
I saw a picture of him, and
I saw a picture too, but he was pretty bloodied and beaten. So really, you know it was him for sure.
Yeah, well, maybe he needed that extra weight to take all those punches from about 15, 20 guys.
Yeah.
Just desserts, huh? They didn't have those at Subway, did they?
Beat me to it.
Thank you. And listen, we don't even have writers.
They don't have desserts.
So that's what's a lot of things are happening. So we
this is off the top of our head, folks.
No way. No, who
we
would
don't
make
rehearse
this up?
Stuff.
Who would make this up?
I don't know.
Hey, tomorrow, great interview that we're going over Main Street clothing,
very on a serious note, I am very much looking forward
excited?
To this. Yeah, I mean, because it's an interview along with, the Hillary situation, it took our crack producing staff quite a long time to book this guest.
Yeah.
And I don't really want to hint as to who whom it may be.
Can I tell you what's going on then on a lighter side of the
not
news?
Interested at all.
Stretch marks. There's a big thing happening Saturday.
St. Patrick's Day.
No, no. This is different.
Okay.
This is with they still have the butt sisters,
right.
The triplets.
Again,
Betty, Bertha,
again,
and Bohemian. Well, guess what?
We have been sent letters by their attorney.
That's right.
It's Butte.
Butte.
not butts.
Triplets. Well, here's what they're doing. It's sit on my face Saturday. So what they do is what they're going to do if you it costs $15. Let me finish. Here's what the thing is. It's a great contest, though. It's almost like as if you were training to be in outer space because of the lack of oxygen. What you do? It's $15, okay? And then you pick a name out of the hat. It's either going to be Bertha, Betty, or Bohemoth. And you have them sit on your face, and they time you. So what happens? What happens? You can win. What happens if you get through the first one? Then they just keep sitting on you, all three sisters. I think it's great. $15. They're trying to. You wait till they have the golf tournament to raise the money golf.
I believe they put your name on a plaque too.
Well, more than that, but here, you know how they have a drink like Sex on a Beach. Well,
right.
You win their new drink. It's you heard of their drink?
I can't wait.
No, I don't know. What? Did you hear it?
No, I haven't heard it. I just can't wait to hear it.
Well, I'm not going to tell the audience because I want them to go down to
Stretch Marks.
Saturday with the Butte, a.k.a. Butt Triplets, Betty, Bertha, and Bohemoth, and it's Sit on Your Face Saturday.
They have come up with a wonderful song, too, to commemorate the night.
What is it?
It's called Sit on My Face, Sit on My Face, Sit on My Face.
Saturday. I forget the name of the drink, though. You could win. It's $15 to get in. Think about that. For $15, you have, I think Betty, Bertha, and Bohemoth, all together, they weigh like a good 1,200 pounds.
I believe, though, Bohemoth, if I'm not mistaken, might not be there.
Why not?
She's in training for the Olympics. She's a power lifter.
She is. Mm-hmm. Well, I just think it's a great deal. For $15, and then after they sit on your face, if you don't, beat the record, then you have food. I guess they're having cocktail wieners down there. They're going to serve.
Right. It's a little known fact that...
But the food down there.
Well, no, the record holder, Owen Stawinski.
Owen!
Yeah, he still holds the record.
What is it?
A minute, two seconds.
And that was just individual sitting on his face, right?
Right. He's like 5'1".
Wow. I remember
Little Irish guy.
I remember. You know what I remember the most?
Well, he had passed out. That's the thing. That's why he survived so long.
Yeah. Here's what I remember the most. I was amazing.
Because he was Irish.
You think really?
Right.
And here's our, so here's what amazes me the most. When Betty got up after sitting on Jesse Owens' face.
Winkowitz.
Everybody, when she walked away, they go, wow, that's a nice tattoo. And here it was Owens' face.
Still stuck to
her butt cheek.
Yeah.
So, wow. It's amazing. I forget the name of that drink, though, that they were serving.
I have no idea.
Sex on a Beach, but I maybe tomorrow it'll come to my mind. I'll have to look at my notes, but it had something to do with camels. I don't know. I don't know. Well, we'll figure it out. Okay, because I'm just saying, huh?
Camels, huh?
Not cigarettes.
No.
Anyway, I don't know.
Something to do with their feet?
No. Anyway, so just a lot of, look at this. Look at this episode. All the information. You got the Trump. You got Jared. You got the
Ham.
Butt, a.k.a. You got Ham the monkey.
The Butte sisters.
He got slipped on the banana. And Jared did it Subway.
Right.
He put on a lot of weight. Maybe he'll end up dancing when he gets out of prison with the
Butte sisters,
mm-hmm. aka the Butt Triplets. So maybe he'll end up sitting on somebody's face forever.
Nope.
I think he already no. He may never get out alive.
Nope.
No, I think he's going to be to a point where I think he's going to do stuff to himself. And it's not going to. You think? I hope so. I hate to say that, but I hope so.
He deserves it.
Yeah, oh my gosh. Anyway, see, this is why back in the day, the mob, this guy would have been dusted. He would have been out.
Why do we always
go to the mob?
Yeah,
Well, who else is going to do it? You don't know this. Let me throw this by. How about
mob
like,
justice?
How about this? When Charles Lindbergh's son was kidnapped.
Hey, I think, little Tony told me that, he's the one who ratted on me, so I'm going to have to knock him in and whack him.
Yeah.
I don't know for a fact, but that's what I heard. So,
But this is the honest to God.
Jury, and executioner. That's right.
Yeah, that'd be a nice t-shirt.
Judge, jury, and executioner.
No. Not Judge Judy. It's Judge, jury, and executioner.
Which, congrats to Judge Judy.
$47 million.
Right. I'm very happy for Judge Judy. Heard that she just got elected to the Supreme Court. I didn't realize that.
No. How'd you? Is that from Obama?
Well, no, that's according to our latest Gallup poll from our college-age students. 30% of the people of college age believe, these are the people that are voting for Bernie Sanders, by the way, the vast majority of them, believe that Judge Judy,
Cary Grant, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. was on the Supreme Court.
That's sad. That's very sad. But, as you well know...
Congratulations, Judge.
$47 million a year. Mm-hmm. Let me do it one more time. And her ratings, out of the last 47 weeks, she has been number one 46 consecutive weeks.
Congratulations.
Judge Judy.
Justice.
$47 million. And the number one game show, what do you think the number one game show is on TV?
Outrageously Big.
No, that's a porn movie I was going to talk to you about.
Oh. Well, we don't have time to talk about it, so.
Well, I guess...
You want to get
we're
to,
short
you
better, on time.
You better get to it quick.
Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, just remember, this is from the Butt Sisters, Betty, Bertha, and Bohemoth. They have a new book out. You're going to love it. In fact, there's going to be a book signing after Sit on Your Face Saturday. There'll be a big book signing with them. So please, pick up a book. It's $15 to get in.
Mm-hmm.
The name of the drink, they have a drink.
$49.95 for the book.
Yeah.
And steal.
$15 for them to sit on your face. That's not a bad deal. That's $60.
I mean, $65 and you're out of there with a book and a story you can tell your grandkids. Folks, you can reach us at NCTV45.com, NCTV45@gmail.com. You can also reach us at 724-510-7345. Folks, we'll be back tomorrow with a wonderful
interview.
That we've been looking forward to.
Pulitzer Prize?
Correct. That would be a book.
Thank you for tuning in.
We're doing an interview.
To the Padula Show Extra with
Jay.
And Jay.
And Jay.
Hi.
Folks, we'll see you later, and I'm going to turn this off now.
Go ahead.
We're on the iPhone.
It's on you, brother.
Turn it off.